And one of the Salaf, the good Salaf, tells us, how do I know if I'm obeying Allah or not? He says, I look at the behavior of my ride, the horse or the camel. If the horse or the camel is obeying me, I know I've obeyed Allah. If the horse and camel are doing something wrong, I know I've disobeyed Allah, subhanAllah. So here maybe we should look at our car and say, if the car is running fine and well, we know that inshaAllah we are obeying Allah. If the car is breaking every day, maybe we should wonder what's happening. Where did we get the money? Is the money we bought the car with halal? Is the money we're fixing the car with halal? All these things, are we reading Quran in the car or? We have to look at, rather than say somebody sold me a bad car. Allahu A'lam, this is one of the Salihin is saying, that's how he knows. And he also says, he knows, he looks at how his wife is treating him. If his wife is treating him nice, he knows he's obeying Allah. If his wife is treating him badly, he knows there's something wrong between his relation between himself and Allah. So they look at their life and look at how things are going, and they relate everything back to their relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَنَا عِنْدَ ظَنَّ عَبْدِي بِي. I, at wherever my servant wants, whatever you think of me, I will be, subhanAllah. So if we think khair, good, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us good, subhanAllah. وَلَا مَعَهُ إِذَا ذَكَرَنِي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us, I am with you if you remember me. If we remember Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with us. And what else do we want? What other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If he remembers me in himself, I remember him by myself. If he remembers me in a crowd, I mention him in a crowd larger than this, subhanAllah. If he remembers me in a crowd, I remember him in a crowd larger. And as I shared with you before, I was invited to a barbecue in the summer a long time ago. And then somebody came and said, Ashraf, we need you to come and give a speech. So here I'm looking, they said this barbecue, some important people are going to be there, and it's good for the business to shake hands and to rub shoulders with these important people. And yet, subhanAllah, I have an invitation to say a talk and mentioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided me that I choose to go and speak and not go to the barbecue. And on Monday, people from work said, Alhamdulillah, you didn't come. It was boring. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had inspired to somebody to mention you and your company and say, help, these are good people, subhanAllah. مَنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي مَجْلِسِ سَكَرْتُوهُ فِي مَجْلِسٍ خَيْرًا مِنْهُ. If you mention me in a crowd, I mention you in a better crowd, subhanAllah. So we have to remember, if we are with Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be with us. And as Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told to the young Muslim, احفظ الله يحفظك. Remember Allah and keep Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remember and keep you. He'll keep you well. He'll take care of you, subhanAllah. احفظ الله يحفظك. احفظ الله تجد تجاهك. If you maintain Allah and keep Allah with you, He will always be with you. وإذا سألت فاسأل الله. If you ask, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وإذا استعنت فاستعن بالله. And if you seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we say in our prayer, every day, إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. We tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we worship you and we seek the help from you. And it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that where we forget, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. Allah is capable of everything. So why should we ask anybody else? A lot of us think we should ask, and there's nothing wrong. We have to work and we have to do things. But subhanAllah, if we obey Allah, before we ask somebody, somebody will offer to help. You will go to somebody and he offers to help. So rather than you asking and embarrassing yourself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes this person want to offer to help you. SubhanAllah. إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ وَإِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ. If you ask, ask Allah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. We seem to have forgotten this. We always, when I tell somebody, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ, Allah is capable of anything, he says, but. Where does it say but? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is called Al-Aziz Al-Hakim. When they describe Al-Aziz, he does not have to account to anybody and say, no, I can do it, but I will not, or I don't, I should, because of something else, because of this but we always put. Aziz means he can do whatever he likes without having to explain to anybody why he did. If we understood the name of Allah Aziz, we would not put the but after إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. فَاللَّهُ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ wise and عزيز, he's not accountable to it. Anybody? So inshallah, when he wants to do something, he can do it, subhanAllah. And this is what we have to understand.